In OAuth 2 or OpenID Connect, people often ask me, what's the difference between an access token and a value token or an ID token? And it's quite simple. First, an access token. When you sign in, for example, using OAuth 2, using an authorization code flow, the login results in the user getting an access token, the user or the application rather. This access token is then used for accessing backend APIs or querying the authentication server. The access token itself is a long string and is typically opaque, which means that it has no specific meaning to the target service or application that's accessing it. They can't, from the token themselves, actually derive any context. In order to find out about the token and what it's for and what it means, they need to call a service called the token introspection service. The token introspection service will tell them what that token represents. It will tell who the issuer is, when it was issued, how long it's valid for, who it was issued to, and any scopes related to how this access token can be used. It's then used, the access token is then used against APIs, either backend APIs, third-party APIs, or APIs issued offered by the authentication service, in order to get information either about the user's identity or about what the user is trying to do in a web service. So the access token typically has no actual information inside of it itself. In contrast, a value token is a signed and possibly encrypted JWT which contains user information or contains information related to the user's current session. When you have a bearer token, you have all the information you need and it's signed. And a backend can verify the signature and then trust the attributes in that value token without having to make an additional network call to the authorization server to check that information again. This increases performance because you don't have to make unnecessary network calls to the authorization server to check that information. When you use access tokens, you don't actually have a payload, you don't have the user information. And when you use an access token, you have to make a call to the authorization server to a token introspection endpoint or to another user info endpoint in order to get information about what that token represents. These additional calls, first the network call, making the connection, connecting to the server, waiting for the server to return the results, interpreting the results from the server, can slow down processing dramatically. So when you're designing the system, the system architect takes into account what transactions are ID tokens, so bearer value tokens, what types of transactions those are relevant for, and what types of transactions an access token is relevant for. And it's important for these experts to decide when the user's information security is important, when we need to protect that as much as possible, and when performance requirements dictate that we'll use a bearer token. The same session can generate multiple different types of ID tokens or JWT tokens containing user information so that different backends get different sets of information. This is ideal in ensuring that the user information is sent to the backends only the minimum amount of information that's relevant to the transaction at hand and not one bit or byte more.